Morning, folks. Jordan here at the Nutty Gnome Homestead. It is October 13th, 2024, and we're out here in our big garden digging some sweet potatoes. As you guys can see, we got this row behind us. You might see some grass growing up in here, and that's because we don't spray anything on any of our gardens. We try to plant as organically as possible here on the Nutty Gnome Homestead. Now, if you guys haven't watched our video of us starting our sweet potato slips, go back and check out that video. It explains the entire process on how we get these sweet potatoes started. We got them planted. They've been in the ground about 145 to 150 days, somewhere right around there. It's time to get these guys out of the ground. So what we're going to do is we're going to come through here. We're going to chop all the grass and the tops down, and then we're going to come back and dig it up. So why don't you guys come along and we'll show you how we harvest our sweet potatoes. And at the end, I'll even explain to you how we cure them for storage. All right, guys. So my preferred tool for cleaning the tops off of these sweet potatoes and cutting down this grass is going to be a hand scythe. We got this nice and sharp. It's going to make real short work of cutting these tops off and getting them laid to the side. So I'm going to get this knocked out real quick, guys. Okay, guys, so as you guys can see, we got the grass cut down here. It does look a lot better. The grass that came off of this row grew out of the row. It didn't grow from in between the rows. In between the rows, I got about 8 inches of wood chips. Not much grows in there. We don't put fabric down or any kind of mulch down over top of our sweet potatoes. So we are going to get some grass and whatnot growing from around them. These vines from the sweet potatoes are going to grow out. They're going to set root anywhere they touch any kind of soil, and they will actually put out a new plant. We've got sweet potatoes here. Now these mounds are 18 inches tall. Here's another sweet potato. A lot of these are real close to the surface. There's another one. There's a whole cluster of them. We planted 60, I think we planted 65. Sweet potatoes. I think we planted 65 sweet potato slips, and we are hoping to get 100 to 200 pounds of sweet potatoes this year. So we've already dug about 50 pounds. We're going to go see what the rest of this row looks like. So come on. All right, guys. So all we're going to do now is we're going to take a potato fork, and we're going to start turning these rows over, trying to see what kind of sweet potatoes we can find. This is real loose soil here. This is our homemade potting mix. This soil is real loose. This is a lot of our own potting mix that we put in here. Lots of compost. There's a little one. There's one. Now, I see that potato's growing down. I want to go right straight down, and I want to dig out from underneath it and try to pop it up. I don't want to hit it with a potato fork, because sometimes that will happen and you'll damage your potatoes. Gently work it out. That's a nice sweet potato right there. A little bit of mouse damage on it. That's all right. After we cure it, we'll cut that off, eat them first. Those are real nice sweet potatoes right there, guys. There's one that didn't actually form a root or into a tuber. It started to, and then it decided to keep on growing. That's all right. I think we're going to have plenty this year. So,
all right, guys. So we're about to
done with this row, and I got a plant of sweet potatoes here that is just absolutely huge. There's like 6 or 7 sweet potatoes coming off of this. They all look really good size. If you look down here, you can see this. I've already loosened up the soil around it with the potato fork. We're just going to keep digging them out. Rock it a little bit. Guys, this is one sweet potato plant. This is how much food you guys can grow in a small space. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sweet potatoes on there, and there might be one more stuck down in the bottom of the soil somewhere. This is why we grow sweet potatoes. My grandparents made it through the Depression with sweet potatoes and chickens. So this is one of those things we'll always be growing on our farm. We're going to finish up digging up the rest of this row, and we'll bring you guys back and show you the total of sweet potatoes.
All right, guys. So what we have here is one of our potatoes that was a little soft. We had 6 inches of rain last week, and where we had the sweet potatoes planted, underneath the rows by about 2 feet, 18 inches to 2 feet or so, does not drain very well. We built our rows up. We built the entire garden up higher. That was so we could actually utilize it. The parts of these potatoes, there's only a couple of them here that grew down that far, are a little soft from being in the water. You can see you got soft spots here. So what we do is we just take our knife and we cut that off until we get down to a hard spot all the way around. And we will cure this just like this. This will heal over, it'll form a callus, and then this will still be able to utilize either for sprouts, growing our sweet potato slips, or we can actually eat it. Okay, so we end up trimming like half a dozen of these potatoes up that had the soft spots on it. Now we're going to get these guys moved over into the greenhouse. So we want these to be in a single layer in the greenhouse for about 10 to 14 days. We're going to try to keep the temperature around 80 to 85 degrees with high humidity, but we want there to be a good airflow in there so the air doesn't get stagnant and these start to form mold or rot. We will put a fan in the greenhouse for the next week and a half or so, and all these potatoes are going to get a nice hard skin after about 10 days to 14 days, and then we can go ahead and store them. If you have a root cellar, that's the perfect place to store them. After they're cured, you will want to get them cooled off and in a dark place as quickly as possible. If you don't have a root cellar, a spare closet, a pantry, even underneath your house, if you don't have any problems with pests, guys, there's plenty of ways to store these sweet potatoes, but we have to cure them first. If you try to eat them right now, they're not going to taste like what you would think a sweet potato is going to taste like. They're going to be very starchy and probably a little bit bitter. By curing them, the starches will convert over to sugars and it'll get that distinct sweet potato flavor that everybody knows and likes. So we've already got the first wheelbarrow load in the greenhouse curing. I'm not going to show you me laying these out in a single file, single layer row. Guys, it really is that simple. Get them out in a row, get them cooled off, or get them in a row, put a fan on them, get the air moving around them, cure them at about 80 to 85 degrees for about two weeks. That's all there is to it, guys. If you guys like this kind of content, please like, share, and subscribe. If you guys have any suggestions for future videos, please let us know down below or contact us over on Nutty Gnome Homestead on Facebook. Guys, this is harvest season. Everybody around us is cutting their corns and beans, getting the last remnants out of their gardens that they can. Winter will be here before you know it. This is one of those good survival foods that we will always have on our farm. So till next time, y'all stay safe.